this lecture, following list of contents have been discussed. It is, what is the main composition of soil, organic, inorganic, water, formation of soil, which is also known as pedogenesis, parent material is classified into different factors as the what type of parent material that involved in the formation of soil, what type of topography, climate change, time and structural and chemical changes that take place in the soil. Physical properties of the soil, function of the soil and plant nutrients, that is the availability of plant nutrients in the soil. Basically, soil has science has two branches, aphidology and pedology. Aphidology studies the influences of soil on living things, and pedology focus on the formation, description, morphology and classification of soil in their natural environment. Now comes to us the soil composition. As the lecture focus on the nature and composition of the soil. Soil composition is an important aspect of nutrient management, while soil minerals, organic matter hold and store nutrients. Soil water is what readily provides nutrients for plant uptake. Soil air too plays an integral role, since many of the microorganisms that live in the soil needed air to undergo biological processes that release additional nutrients into the soil. The basic components of the soil are minerals, that is organic matter, water and air. The typical soil consists of 45% inorganic material, 5% organic material, 20-30% water and 20-30% air. These percentages are only generalization based. In reality, the soil is very complex and dynamic. The composition of the soil can fluctuate on daily basis, depending on the numerous factors such as water supply, cultivation practices or soil type. Now the soil particles are basically that range from 0.1 to 2 millimeter in diameter are thin, and the soil particle between 0.002 and 0.1 millimeter are called silt, and even smaller particles less than 0.002 millimeter in diameter are called clay particles. Sometimes soil that have no dominant particle size, that containing a mixture of sand, silt and humus, these soil are called loams. Loams basically the soil with no dominant particle size, right, that contain the mixture of sand, silt and humus. Humus, as it has been already well defined in previous lectures, a large group of naturally organic compounds found in the soil that composed of decaying plants and dead and living microorganisms is known as humus. Now the inorganic part, inorganic component, mineral matter of the soil is composed of many types of minerals that influence the properties of the soil. The difference among the soil are basically due to differences in the type and relative abundance of such minerals. Hence the soil of specific area different properties than the soil of other. Minerals are naturally occurring inorganic compounds having definite crystalline structures. They are classified into primary and secondary minerals. Primary minerals basically are those minerals that are formed at elevated temperature and inherited unchanged from igneous and metamorphic rock, where the secondary minerals are formed at low temperature reactions and either inherited from the sedimentary rocks or formed directly by weathering in soil. Sand and silt fractions consist mainly of quartz, and other primary minerals, feldspar, mica, pyroxene, olivine. In addition, some small amounts of secondary minerals such as oxides of aluminum, gypsite and iron, hematite are also found. The clay fraction is mainly composed of secondary silicate minerals such as केलोनाइट, इलाइट एंड मोंट मोरिलोनाइट. सो सॉइल ऑर्गेनिक मैटर बेसिकली कंसिडर्ड कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू जनरल ग्रुप. फ्रेश और पार्शली डिकम्पोज प्लांट एंड एनिमल रेजिड्यूज हैविंग सम फिजिकल स्ट्रक्चर ट्रेसेबल टू इट्स ओरिजिन. सेकेंड इज द ह्यूमस, विच इज मोस्ट रेजिस्टेंट प्रोडक्ट ऑफ डीकम्पोजिशन एंड कोलाइडल इन नेचर. इट इज द ब्लैक और ब्राउन कलर यूजली ऑब्जर्व इन द सर्फेस लेयर्स ऑफ द सॉइल. एज डिस्कस्ड इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर, इट इज द ब्लैक और ब्राउन कलर बेसिकली इज ड्यू टू द प्रेजेंस ऑफ ह्यूमस. ह्यूमस इज मोस्ट एक्टिव पार्ट ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक मैटर बेसिकली ड्यू टू इट्स स्ट्रक्चर. इट्स कैपेसिटी टू होल्ड वाटर एंड न्यूट्रिएंट्स ग्रेटली एक्सीड देन डैट ऑफ क्ले इट्स इनऑर्गेनिक काउंटर पार्ट. द फ्रेश एंड पार्शली डिकम्पोज प्लांट एंड एनिमल रेजिड्यू अकर इन सैंड एंड सिल्ट फ्रैक्शन ऑफ द सॉइल एंड ह्यूमस अकर इन द क्ले फ्रैक्शन ऑफ द सॉइल. सॉइल फॉर्मेशन इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ फाइव फैक्टर्स बेसिकली द पेरेंट मटीरियल, वट इज द इट्स क्लाइमेट, वट इज द टोपोग्राफी, वट इज द बायोलॉजिकल फैक्टर्स दैट ह्यूमन बींग्स, माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म, एनिमल्स आर इंक्लूड इन टू द बायोलॉजिकल फैक्टर एंड द टाइम फॉर दीज प्रोसेस टेक्स प्लेस. सॉइल फॉर्मेशन इज द कॉन्सिक्वेंस ऑफ द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ बायोलॉजिकल, फिजिकल एंड केमिकल प्रोसेस. सॉइल आइडियली कंटेन 50% सॉलिड मटीरियल एंड 50% पोर स्पेसिस. अबाउट वन हाफ ऑफ द पोर स्पेसिस शुड कंटेन वाटर वाइल अदर हाफ ऑफ द कंटेन एयर. द ऑर्गेनिक कंपोनेंट ऑफ द सॉइल सर्व एज सीमेंटिंग एजेंट दैट इज रिटर्न्स न्यूट्रिएंट्स टू द प्लांट्स, अलाउज सॉइल्स टू स्टोर मॉइस्चर, मेक सॉइल टिलेबल फॉर फार्मिंग एंड प्रोवाइड एनर्जी फॉर सॉइल माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म. मोस्ट सॉइल माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म बैक्टीरिया, एल्गी, फंजी आर डोमिनेंट इन ड्राई सॉइल बट बिकम्स एक्टिव वंस मॉइस्चर इज अवेलेबल. सॉइल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन बेसिकली इज नॉट होमोजीनियस बिकॉज इट्स फॉर्मेशन रिजल्ट इन द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ डिफरेंट लेयर. एज वर्टिकल सेक्शन ऑफ द लेयर ऑफ द सॉइल इज कॉल्ड सॉइल प्रोफाइल. विद इन द सॉइल प्रोफाइल सॉइल साइंटिस्ट डिफाइन डिफरेंट जोन, दिस आर नोन एज होरिजन्स. इट्स सॉइल लेयर्स विद डिस्टिंक्ट फिजिकल केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज दैट डिफर फ्रॉम दोज ऑफ द अदर लेयर is known as horizon. That is, if one portion of the horizon having physical and chemical properties than the other portion of the horizons in the layer. Five factors account for the soil formation that already mentioned, that is the parent material, climate, topography, biological factors and time, which will be discussed in the next slide. Now, what is the parent material? The organic and inorganic material in which soil form is known as parent material. Mineral soil, that is the inorganic soil, formed directly from the weathering of bedrock, the solid rock that lies beneath the soil. Therefore, they have a similar composition to original rock. Other soils form in the material that came from elsewhere, such as sand and glacial drift. Materials located in the depth of the soil are unchanged compared with the deposited material. Sediments in the river may have different characteristics depending on whether the stream moves quickly or slowly. A fast moving river could have sediments of rocks and sand, whereas a slow moving river could have fine textured material such as clay. Typically, soil parent mineral materials are quartz, that include silicon oxide, calcite, calcium carbonate, feldspar, potassium aluminum silicate, silicate oxide, mica, boehmite. It's also a complex including potassium, magnesium, iron, aluminum silicate, hydroxyl form of aluminum silica oxide. Parent material are classified according to how they came to be deposited. Residual materials are mineral material that have weathered in place from primary bedrock. Transported material are those that have deposited in water with bind ice or gravity. Cumulose parent material is not moved but originates from deposited organic material. This include peat, pit, muck soil and results from the preservation of plant residue by low oxygen content of high water table, while pit may from stealized soil, muck soil may be very straight fertile. Physical and chemical disintegration. Temperature fluctuation cause expansion and contraction of rock, splitting it along the lines of weakness. Water may enter the crack and freeze and cause the physical splitting of material along a path towards the center of the rock, while temperature gradient within the rock can cause exfoliation of shells. Cycles of wetting and drying cause soil particles to be abraded to finer size, as does the physical rubbing of material as it is moved by wind, water and gravity. Water can deposit within the rock material minerals that expand upon drying, thereby stressing the rock. Finally, organisms reduce parent material in size and create pores through the mechanical action of the plant roots and digging activity of the animal. Physical disintegration begins as rocks that have solidified deep in the earth are exposed to lower pressure near the surface and swell and become mechanically unstable. Chemical decomposition is a function of mineral solubility, the rate of which doubles with each 10 degrees Celsius rise in temperature, but is dependent on the water to effect chemical change. Rocks that will decompose in few years in tropical climate will remain unaltered for millennia in desert. Structural changes are the result of hydration, oxidation and reduction process. Chemical weathering mainly results from the excretion of organic acids in chelating compounds by bacteria and fungi through thought to increase under present day greenhouse, as all of you are aware of greenhouse effect, greenhouse gases that cause the greenhouse effect. Chemical decomposition and structural changes result when minerals are made soluble by water are changed into the are changed in structure. The first three of the following are the solubility changes and the mentioned in the next slide. The solution of salt in the water results from the action of bipolar water molecules on ionic salt compounds. It produces solution of ions and water, remove those minerals and reducing the rock integrity at a rate depending on water flow and pore channel. Now the next change is the hydrolysis. Hydrolysis is the transformation of minerals into polar molecules by splitting intervening water. What is meant? It means it results in the soluble acid base pair. For example, hydrolysis of orthoclase feldspar transforms orthoclase feldspar into the acid silicate clay and basic potassium hydroxide, both of which are soluble. The next process, carbonation. Carbonation means the solution of carbon dioxide in water forms the carbonic acid. Carbonic acid will transform calcite into more soluble calcium bicarbonate. Hence, the conversion of calcite into more soluble calcium bicarbonate in the presence of carbonic acid. Hydration is the addition of water, simply if you define it. Hence, with reference to this context, hydration is the inclusion of water in the mineral structure, causing it to swell and leaving it stressed and easily decomposed. Oxidation is simply the addition of oxygen. Oxidation of mineral compound means inclusion or addition of oxygen in a mineral that increases the oxidation number and swell due to large size of oxygen, leaving it stressed and more easily attacked by water. That is the process of hydrolysis, or more easily the process of carbonic acid attack or carbonation takes place. So the next is reduction. Reduction, the opposite of oxidation, means the removal of oxygen. Hence, the oxidation number of some part of the mineral is reduced, which occurs when oxygen is scarce or deficient, you can say. The reduction of minerals leaves them electrically unstable, more soluble and internally stressed and easily decomposed. It mainly occurs in water locked conditions. Chemical weathering becomes more effective as the surface area of the rock increases. This is favored by the physical disintegration. These seven processes that take place. No climate, temperature, moisture, wind cause different patterns of weathering that affect the soil characteristics. The presence of moisture and nutrients from weathering will also promote biological activity, a key component of quality of soil. The principal climatic variables influence soil formation are effective precipitation, that is precipitation minus evapotranspiration, and temperature, both of which affect the rates of chemical, physical and biological processes. Temperature and moisture both influence the organic matter content of the soil through their effects on the balance between primary production and decomposition. The colder or drier the climate, the lesser atmospheric carbon is fixed as organic matter, while the lesser organic matter is decomposed. Climate is the dominant factor in soil formation, and soils show the distinctive characteristics of the climate zone in which they form. With a feedback to climate through transfer of carbon stock in soil horizons back to the atmosphere. If warm temperature and abundant water are present in the profile at the same time, the process of weathering, leaching and plant growth will maximize. According to climatic determination of biomass, humid climate favor growth of trees. Grasses are the dominant native vegetation in the subhumid and semi-arid regions, while shrubs and bushes of various kinds dominate in the arid areas. Climate also indirectly influences soil formation through the effect of vegetation cover and biological activity, which modify the rates of chemical reactions in the soil. Essential of water for all major chemical weathering reactions, as the seasonal rainfall distribution, evaporative losses, site topography, soil permeability, intended to determine how effectively precipitation can influence soil formation. The greater the depth of water penetration, the greater the depth of weathering of the soil in its development. Hence, you can say by this statement that surplus water percolating through the soil profile transports soluble and suspended material from the upper layer, that is इलुवेशन टू द लोअर लेयर दैट इज आइलुवेशन इंक्लूडिंग क्ले पार्टिकल्स एंड डिजॉल्व ऑर्गेनिक मैटर. इट मे आल्सो कैरी अवे सॉल्युबल मटेरियल्स इन द सरफेस ड्रेनेज वॉटर दस परकुलेटिंग वॉटर स्टिमुलेट वेदरिंग रिएक्शन एंड हेल्प डिफ्रेंशिएट सॉइल होरिजन. लाइक वाइज डेफिशंसी ऑफ वॉटर इज ए मेजर फैक्टर इन डिटरमाइनिंग द करेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ सॉइल ऑफ ड्राई रीजन. वॉटर इज ए मेजर फैक्टर इन डिटरमाइनिंग द करेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ सॉइल ऑफ वेट एंड वेट रीजन. सॉल्युबल सॉइल्स आर नॉट लीच्ड फ्रॉम दीज ड्राई सॉइल्स एंड इन सम केसेज दे बिल्ड अप द लेवल्स दैट कर्टेल द प्लांट एंड माइक्रोबियल ग्रोथ. द डायरेक्ट इंफ्लुएंस ऑफ क्लाइमेट इंक्लूड शेलो एक्यूमुलेशन ऑफ लाइम इन ए लो रेनफॉल एरियाज, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एसिड सॉइल्स इन ह्यूमिड एरियाज, इरोजन ऑफ सॉइल ऑन स्टीप हिल साइड, डेपोजिशन ऑफ इरोडेड मटीरियल्स डाउनवर्ड, वेरी इंटेंस केमिकल वेदरिंग, लीचिंग, इरोजन इन वार्म वाटर, वार्म ह्यूमिड रीजन्स वेयर सॉइल डजंट फ्रीज. The effectiveness of water in weathering parent rock material depends on the seasonal and daily temperature fluctuation, which favor tensile stresses in rock minerals and thus their mechanical disaggregation. Basically, the process of mechanical disaggregation is known as thermal fatigue. Hence, the water is very essential for all major chemical weathering reaction takes place. Now the next factor is the topography. Regional surface features known as the lay of plants can have major influence on the fertility of the soil. Topography affects water runoff, which strips away parent material and affects plant growth. Steep soils are more prone to erosion and may be thinner than the soils that are relatively flat. The topography or relief is characterized by the inclination, that is slope, elevation and orientation of the terrain. Topography determines the rate of precipitation or runoff and the rate of formation or erosion of the surface soil profile. The topographical setting may either hasten or retard the work of climatic forces. Steep slopes encourage rapid soil loss by erosion and allow less rainfall to enter the soil before running off, and hence little mineral deposition in lower profile. As in semi-arid region, the low effective rainfall on steeper slopes also result in less complete vegetative cover, so there is less plant contribution to the soil formation. For all these reasons, steep slopes prevent the formation of soil from getting very far ahead of soil destruction. Hence, you can say soil on steep terrain tend to have rather shallow, poor developed profile in comparison to soil on nearby sites. Depression in the soil allow the accumulation of water, minerals, organic matter, and in the extreme resulting the soil will be saline marshes. Intermediate topography affords the best condition for the formation of culturally productive soil. Now the next factor is time, as time is the important factor in soil formation. Because soils develop over long periods, soil formation is a dynamic process. Materials are deposited over time, decomposed and transformed into other materials that can be used by living organisms or deposited on the surface of the soil. Biological factors, the plants, animals, include plants, animals, fungi, bacteria, humans that affect the soil formation. Soil animals including soil macro fauna, soil mesofauna, mixed the soil as they form burrows and pores, allowing moisture and gases to move about, a process called by turbation. In the same way, plant roots penetrate soil horizons and open channels upon decomposition. Plants with the deep tap roots can penetrate many meters through the different soil layers to bring up nutrients from deeper in the profile. Plants have fine roots that excrete organic compounds, sugars, organic acids. Microorganisms including fungi and bacteria effect chemical exchange between the roots and soil and act as a reserve of nutrients in the soil biological hotspot called rhizosphere. The presence of organism affects soil formation and structure. Animal and microorganisms can produce pores. Plant roots can penetrate into the pores to produce more fragmentation. Plant secretions promote the development of microorganisms around the root in that area of rhizosphere. Additionally, leaves and other materials that fall from the plant decompose and contribute to the soil composition. Soil is the major abundant, most abundant ecosystem on earth. But vast majority of organisms in the soil are microbes, a great array of which have not been described. The total number of organisms and species vary according to the soil type, location and depth. Human impact soil formation by removing vegetation, cover with orion, water logging. Their tillage also mixes different soil layers, just restarting the soil formation process as less weather material is mixed with the more developed upper layers, resulting in net increased rate of mineral weathering. Now the next is physical properties of the soil. As it has been mentioned previously in slides that soil are made of a combination of different distinct layer types or horizons that known as these different horizons as O horizon named A horizon, B horizon and C horizon. Each horizon has a distinct and separate portion of sand, distinct layer of soil than the other type of horizon. As in this picture, the O horizon, basically O horizon has freshly decomposing organic matter, humus at its surface with decomposed vegetation at its base. Humus enriches the soil with nutrients, enhancing soil moisture retention. Topsoil, the top layer of the soil is usually 2 to 3 inches deep, but this depth can vary considerably. For instance, river deltas such as have deep layers of the topsoil. Topsoil is rich in organic material, that's why it's known as O horizon. Microbial process occur there. It is responsible for the plant production, that is the major characteristics of the topsoil. The A horizon consists of a mixture of organic material with inorganic material of weathering. It is the beginning of true mineral soil. The horizon is typically darkly colored because the presence of organic matter in the soil, and it is mixed with the inorganic matter. In this area, rainwater percolates through the soil and carries materials from the surface towards the soil. Now the B horizon, which is also known as subsoil. In B horizon is the accumulation of mostly fine material that has moved downward, resulting in the dense layer in the soil. B horizon contains nodules or a layer of calcium carbonate. Now the next is the C horizon. C sea origin basically also known as soil base. It includes the parent material plus the organic and inorganic material that is broken down to form the soil. Now you can say the parent material may be either created in its natural place or transported from elsewhere to its present location. Beneath the sea horizon, there is the layering of bedrock material. This is all about the horizons or layer of soil beneath the soil layer. Soil, if you can define the soil, soil is the major component of the ecosystem. The word ecosystem are impacted in four reaching ways by the process carried out in the soil, that is the from ozone depletion and global warming to rainforest destruction and water pollution. With respect to Earth's carbon cycle, soil is an important carbon reservoir and is potentially one of the most reactive to human disturbance and climate change. As the planet warms, it has been predicted that soil will add carbon dioxide to the atmosphere due to increased biological activity at higher temperature, that is a positive feedback or amplification. Soil acts as engineering medium, a habitat for soil organism, a recycling system for the nutrients and organic waste, regulator of water quality, a modifier of atmospheric composition, and a medium for plant growth, making it critically important provider of ecosystem. The function of the soil also to remove impurities, kill disease agents, degrade contaminants. The degradation of contaminant being called the natural attenuation. Typically, soil maintain a net absorption of oxygen and methane and undergo a net release of carbon dioxide and nitrous oxide. Soil offer plant physical support, air, water, temperature, nutrient, protection from toxins. Soil provide readily available nutrients to the plants and animals by converting dead organic matter into various nutrient forms. You can say that water is the critical agent in the soil development due to involvement in the precipitation, erosion, transport and deposition of the material of which soil is composed. The mixture of the water and dissolved or suspended material that occupy the soil pore space is called soil solution. Since soil water is never pure water but contains hundreds of dissolved organic and mineral substances, it may more accurately called the soil solution. Water is the central to dissolution, precipitation and leaching of minerals from the soil profile. Water affects the type of vegetation that grow on a soil, which in turn affects the development of the soil, a complex feedback. Soil supply plants with nutrients, most of which are held in place of particles by particles of clay, organic matter. The nutrients may be absorbed on clay mineral surfaces, bound within the clay minerals, bound within the organic compounds or a part of living organism, dead soil organic matter. These bound nutrients interact with the soil water to buffer the soil solution composition. As soil wet up or dry out, as plants take up nutrients, as salts are leached or acid or alkalis are added. Plant nutrient availability is affected by soil pH, which is a measure of the hydrogen ion activity in the soil solution. Soil pH is a function of many soil forming factors and is low. Low mean that is the more acid where weathering is more advanced. Most plant nutrients with the exception of nitrogen originate from the minerals that make up the soil parent material. Some nitrogen originates from the rain as dilute nitric acid and ammonia, but nitrogen is available in the soil as a result of nitrogen fixation by bacteria. This nitrogen fixation by bacteria is has been already discussed in previous lecture. Once in the soil plant system, most nutrients are recycled through living organism, plant and microbial residues, mineral bound forms and soil solutions. Both living microorganisms and soil organic matter are of critical importance to this recycling and soil formation and soil fertility. Microbial activity in the soil may release nutrients from minerals or organic matter for the use by the plant and other microorganisms, or cause their losses from the soil by volatilization or leaching.